What's an aimbot?
Yo, so with how many comments and messages I got after doing the first tips video that I did with Widowmaker like this, I decided to go ahead and do a second. It really helped out a lot of you guys, and I feel like I know even more that I can keep uploading these and really, really give you guys some knowledge and insight into playing Widowmaker. So 99% of you are going to learn something from this video, I can guarantee it. But there's going to be the 1% that know these spots. I mean, the game's been out for over a year already, right? So if you put a lot of time into the game, this video is probably not for you. But I can guarantee you that 99% of you are going to learn something. So with that said, we'll start with Hanamura. Whether you're attacking or defending, let's just say you're attacking. You can come up here. You can kind of get a higher ground for up in here. I mean, lots of people like to come through this window. I prefer to use it for defending, to be honest. So if you stand up here when you're defending, right? And the enemy team comes through their spawn, they're wrapping underneath. You can get a shot or two on people going through the front door before they even notice that you're here. And to get out, all you need to do is hook there and you're out. Back on the high ground and everything. Super easy. Really useful. This next spot is pretty sweet. Thing that kind of sucks is you kind of got your vision is kind of blurred by the tree, but you're really well covered in here. So I'm defending, Chicken's attacking. Thing is I can see Chicken right now, but he can't see me. And I can see perfectly through this window, and I can see the front door, but it's my vision's kind of blocked, so it's not ideal, but it is pretty sweet because you can shoot through this, and you can't be seen. So this is what the spot looks like if you're attacking. So I walk out, and I have my friend Chicken Man sitting in that spot. Sniper. You can't see him. I mean, if you actually scope in, you can see the outline of him. But now you can actually see him, and he can see exactly what I showed you before. Really good spot, but like I said, if you shoot once or twice from there, people are gonna know that you're shooting from there because they can see your bullet trail. So let's say you're defending final point and you know the enemy team walked up those stairs and they're going up top left. Your team is saying, oh, they're pushing up top left, they're probably in that corner, right? What I like to do is come up here and I like to stand on this ledge. So usually you'll see the Mercy or Zenyatta or something, usually sitting in the back, sometimes an Honor or whatever, but the squishies, right? The Ryan and the whatever, their main tanks are going to be pushing through the choke where their supports and stuff are going to be in the back. So if you come up here to defend, you can get easy kills on anything that's trying to walk in. So this one might be well known, but I figured I'd put this one in here too. So like, let's say you're attacking and you're getting to this last point, right? And you need to get up somewhere or whatever, like you're trying to flank or whatever. You can actually hook here and get up here. Sometimes you can do it without even being seen. So it's a pretty good spot. Most of the time when you have a Widow and you're attacking, they kind of post up through the windows or whatever, or shoot through the main sight line. They don't really expect a Widow to come through the side door and hook up here. So could be useful at some point, but lots of people don't know that there's this little hole here to hook up. So attacking on Hollywood, you have the generic hook shot spot, right? Everybody knows, hook here, jump, you can see through the back, right? I have found that a lot of Widows, when they hook there, they don't hook properly and they actually fall to the other side, and that's a big throw. So to eliminate that problem, you can actually come to this side and use the tree rather than using the wall for vantage. Seems to work out a little bit better, whichever you prefer, but pretty generic like I said, but the tree can help out a lot of guys that seem to fall over that roof. So this next spot I'm gonna show you is a defending spot. I'm pretending like I'm attacking, my friend Chicken Man is defending. So when you have flankers come in here, if there's an enemy Widow, a lot of the times they'll be standing up there. Well, you can actually stand back there.
No one can hide.
And you get the exact same vantage that you would from up there, except you're not seen. So people will mistake thinking that you're not up there, while you are up there. And this is what it looks like from here. So you get the exact same sight line, except you can't be seen from that side. So this next spot's for attackers. Let's say you just want a team fight, payload is moving, and you want to try to spawn camp people that are coming out of these two doors. A good spot to come is actually on top of these boxes. So you can head glitch these boxes, and you can see my friend Chicken as he's walking out, free kills. Nice thing is you have the mega right here in case you get rushed. And a pretty easy getaway because you'll have your hook guaranteed. So One last spot for Hollywood that's kind of out of the ordinary. Let's say you're attacking, payload's right at the choke, your team is fighting for that last little push, right? Well, most of the times if there's a Widow, the enemy team is going to be staring right where we are, right? Right behind these boxes. Well, you can actually hook on top of this purple painting thing, and you can sit up here. So if the enemy team has a tracer or something that's trying to get you, right? Sniper. Like, they're going to check behind the boxes. I mean, you can shoot from up here, and you can shoot the car. So it could work out, or it could be a failure. Either way, it could be something to try. Something different. So this next tip, it's not really a secret spot or anything like that. It's just kind of the way that I would start attacking on Umbani. So I would come through this middle door, and I would hook this as fast as I can. I'm saying, like, the second the game starts, I'm up here. You jump at the peak of your hook and always scope in at this top area, because 9 times out of 10 there's going to be a Junkrat or Symmetra, like, something is up there, and what they're trying to do is try to get some free ult charge right when the game starts by spamming at this little area. So they're going to be looking down here, tunnel vision. They're not going to notice the Widowmaker that hooks right at the corner, so you can get a cheeky kill right off the start and give your team the advantage. Okay, so let's just say the first point has been taken. The payload is coming, it's moving around the corner, the team is standing on it. I'm pretending like I'm attacking. I have my friend Chicken Man defending, okay? So, car comes around the corner, and
no one can hide.
That is what you see. Perfect spot for a Widowmaker, because you can't be seen when you're crouched, and you can head glitch and you can see everything down there. So this is what it looks like from this perspective. So Chicken will go down there. This is what it looks like. You can see everything on the car. I would recommend putting your mind in this door here, but you can see everything. And if anything gets hairy, all you need to do is just crouch. Nobody can see you. Nice thing about this spot is you have a mega health kit right here, and you also have a small health kit in this room. So let's say you're coming to the last point, the payload's right there. Most of the time as Widow, you're probably gonna be up here in that corner, or even just down here with your team. If you have enough time, you can actually come way over to this corner. And again, this is situational, because sometimes you may not have enough time. But you can stand over here and you can actually spawn camp them as they come out, and they're not going to be able to pay attention to you because they're going to be worrying about the car. I mean, you're right at the end, right? So if they don't stop the car, you're going to lose that fight. So you can basically be uncontested here, and if anybody comes to contest you, then you're bringing a player off their team and your team has an advantage on the car. I mean, you only have a little bit more to push. So I know I did Watch Point Gibraltar in the last video, but I kind of wanted to add a couple more in. So let's say you get the payload to here. Next checkpoint, car starts moving up here. Most Widows would stand right here, or down low. Problem with this is that you have no cover. So you can actually come over here, stand on these barrels, crouch, and you can shoot the main sight line as the payload moves up. So really good spot. Next spot is actually around this corner. So a lot of people just think that Widowmaker is good for, you know, killing people, right? One hit kills. But you don't necessarily have to get kills to be good for your team. I mean, you hook there and you can come behind the enemy team, right? So now you're behind the enemy team, they're shooting the car, your team is moving forward. Using Chicken Man as an example, oh, I sneak behind, if I even just shoot my gun like this and he turns around, even if I miss, he turns around and now he's looking at me, and the rest of his team is probably gonna turn, at least one other person is gonna turn around. That gives my team the advantage, and you can do whatever the hell you want. You don't even have to shoot anything. You can hide, you can chill back here. Forcing the enemy team off the payload to come for you is just as good as you killing people, so remember that. Really good flank to get behind the enemy. And it also works both ways. So even if you want to go back to the other side, you can do that too. So I kind of wanted to add Blizzny World at the end of the video, but to be completely honest, aside from major sight lines and whatnot, there's no real secret spots or anything. Maybe on top of this tank over here, spawn camping and whatnot, but other than that, there's nothing really. But regardless, I hope you guys did learn something in this video, just like the first. I mean, the game's been out for over a year now, so a lot of these are known to most people. So I hope you learned something. The main point to get across in this video, though, is to be creative with what you're doing. Don't stay in the same spot for too long, and just be, I don't know, just be creative, I guess, is the way you want to be. I'm kind of thinking about doing, like, a control map guide, because Widow kind of sucks on control maps, and poor Chicken. I'm kind of thinking about doing, like, a control map thing, because, like I said, Widow kind of sucks on control. Really, Blizzard? Widow kind of sucks on control maps, and I think it would be interesting to see how to play control with her. And I'm kind of thinking about doing like an actual gameplay with it. Let me know if you want to see that. If you do, I'll do it. If not, ending ruined. If not, we won't do it. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.